things I wish I had another chance at. But I was taught you got liver regrets. I did my skip to the new thing with the team through the streets. Like young Rafer through the Rucker Park D's in 93.
Yep. All right, welcome to the In Perspective Sports Show. I'm your host, that nigga, Roderick Horton. I got my niggas with me back in here tonight. I got the guru in here with me, of course, Willie Hubs. I got my man's Fred, Chris Corbin. I got my man, the big man, Sherman Corbin. And of course, I got the ghost, the superstar, the one, Nick Emerson. Holla at me.
How y'all doing?
Y'all good?
What's going on?
Hey, before we get started,
what's up?
I'm going to dedicate this show to James Caldwell, my man.
That's right.
Word up.
Damn, you got the best seat in the house, so sit back and enjoy the show.
God bless you, James.
Word up.
Let's get this started.
That's right.
Just to start out with some passion, I love that. And it just brings me to a little sports part, you know what I'm saying? Talking about some passion in the game and really feeling, you know what I'm saying, like you really into the game and doing your thing, you know what I'm saying? And what I'm seeing is some kind of watering down in the game. Last night they blew so many whistles in the fucking game with the Pacers and the Heat, I couldn't believe it. They threw Stevenson out on looking at Dwayne Wade, man. They said LeBron went up and did a motherfucking elbow in the middle of a shot. He said, hey, well, my ninja, I'm with him. Like, come on, what's going on? If you look at the screen, folks, I'm showing the damn the hockey match from the other night.
Wow.
Look, they losing their fucking minds. They beat the shit out of each other. I can't put the balance in. I'm trying to figure out what's going on with that from a real perspective. Somebody talk to me. Somebody talk to me.
Man, whenever Stevenson went out of the game, I really like even the first technical. You know, I mean, I understood he had the man, but the way it looked to me like he was holding, you know, holding him back from falling, you know what I'm saying? Okay, all right, I get that technical.
Right.
All right, I still felt like it was wow, you know what I'm saying? But when it comes down to the one where he was looking at Dwayne Wade and the way Wade smiled, you know what I'm saying? I mean, you know, and the throw, I mean, that could have made the difference in that ball game. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I mean, there was a bunch of shit that just dictated too much shit in the game. Really, I know you've seen something. Talk to me. I was disgusted with this.
Is it getting sissified now?
They trying to sissify the game, but when there ain't no passion in the play, man, it's like, who wants to see these bum-ass niggas? I want to see niggas that fit. I go to the rec and see some niggas playing with some real passion. Right. If this nigga's on TV, ain't gonna play with passion. I'd be down if I'm going to tune in to see him, and that's what the league is doing. It's like, a point that you make, they putting corporate bullshit on the game. That's protecting them like it's some kind of factory or some bullshit. What's up, though, Nick? Somebody holler at me. What's up?
I don't know, man. It's just, I don't know. That's a hard one to touch, man. I mean, they look like they, you know, they try to make it, you know, the four-point play. That's how you bring that in. You know, it's something like you let the game less physical and keep moving the line back. Because if you really think about it, early, they were cutthroat.
Right, right.
Them niggas was chopping each other in the throat.
Right.
And they wasn't making no money. You know what I'm saying?
No, like they ought to
but
be.
As it got on TV more and more, you know, you couldn't touch. And that's how the three-point line got in there. Really?
Yeah. I can feel that, too.
You know.
Right.
And I don't know.
I'm just not feeling it.
I ain't feeling it.
They also could be doing it for hype, though.
I'm saying there was something in the game close regardless. I'm saying there was something dictated. I'm feeling that. I got another NCAA college basketball tournament going on right now. There's no way they was gonna have that game lopsided.
About money and ratings.
Hey, as a matter of fact, if you really think about it, the last couple of years, it's been a lot of blowouts in them early series. They don't make no fucking money.
No.
And they just sold the advertised space, so they got to get that shit back.
Yeah,
so right. That might be what the fuck is. You're exactly right. It's going to be a lot of game sevens in these playoffs.
It's about that
money. That paper.
The ratings, the money.
He hit it on the head.
No doubt. I'm still saying that they making these boys look like pussies on the court.
They ain't pussies. Quit wearing them damn skinny jeans.
Please. You don't see no more. You don't see any more bad boys.
Y'all gonna bring the fanny pack back, bitches. Yeah.
Men don't.
No more bad
men
boys.
Don't have yeast infections.
Ah, I know. That's right.
Okay, I'm gonna swing it for a second. NCAA. This is what I saw today. Northwestern players want a bid to unionize their players with Chicago Labor Board, and Northwestern plans to appeal. Is this a big deal? Really, given the players of this college are really going to be at the table when it comes to seeing how all this money is divvied up. Whether or not that means they're paying, getting paid to play, it could be coming in the future. But the thing is that there's a debate that's really having to be dealt with right now. Some money going towards these students. Something that's more than just scholarship money. What do you think? I'm with it. I mean, I've always said it.
Somebody's can't open up the floodgates for the union.
The floodgates. And I said, I don't know if the union's
exactly
the way.
That's what it is.
I don't know if the union's the way because then you got to deal with firing a student then from playing on your team, like firing him.
Yes.
And I don't think that's the way with a union. I don't know if that's the way, but to let them come to the table, I think that's way overdue. What you got?
Well, they're already employees. From what they said, if you really think about it,
mm-hmm. free labor.
You right? got to go out there and practice 20 hours a week.
Mm-hmm. Sweatshop.
You got to go to school.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? You got to get on that bus and promote their fucking, you know, their name on your back.
Right.
But here's what's, you know, okay. Now, Northwestern's pretty fucking smart. Mm-hmm. Hold up now. Do you know how many niggas is going to come up at a motherfucking playing fest the first school? They winning basketball, football, lacrosse.
Think about that.
You know, the first one in on that's going to monopolize, buddy.
So you saying what?
I think it's a scam. They like, we going for it. They're daring, like, let's go for it. Everybody else is gonna sit back and say we don't want, you know, we're not into that.
That's what I'm saying.
Cause they got the
union ain't stupid.
Well, no, it ain't just that. You got to think like the Alabama, the football. Right. Them conferences got the fucking TV rights is going way over there now.
Them's the ones like who's
not Northwestern ain't on that level.
Texas, they want them Texas that has $1 billion industry right there.
Texas has their own network.
It's crazy. I mean, it's billions.
Yeah, he's making $3-4 million.
That's the reason. That goes back to the reason why I think that is a good thing for the kids because, man, well, you got. Let me give you a prime example. Like Maurice Correct. You know what I'm saying? I mean, it was horse junk for this dude, what he's putting on the field for these, the injuries, this and that and that and this. He go back to his dorm, study. He got to eat some ramen noodles. You know what I'm saying? Man, let that boy get him a steak. You know what I'm saying? I mean, at the end of the day, you know.
He fucked up.
I feel you, but still, at the end of the day, you know, the NCAA screwed him. You know what I'm saying? They didn't want him. Hey, wait a minute. They didn't want this young dude at the age he was 19. This dude was physically and a specimen that was ready for the NFL. They went and broke this young kid down. Broke him down. You know what I'm saying? You seen it on the 30 for 30. You know what I'm saying? They broke him down. Broke him down to the point where he had to serve time in prison. If a institution can do that, yeah, them kids should be able to.
He won't do it.
Speaking of 30 for 30,
he didn't steal no cell phones.
Have you watched the Fab Five?
Yes. Yes,
that exactly. That says it all.
That says it all.
I'm fucking balling my ass off. My school's number one. I go to Colorado, bumfuck Egypt, mm-hmm. and I see my shirt at the motherfucker store.
I see
my name
Fab Five sneakers.
Yeah, come on, man. I see sneakers. I see paraphernalia all out the ass. Right.
I'm scraping
come on,
money
anybody
to get
just watch that right there. I think that should be exhibit number one. Well, that's on paying students. That's the 30-30 with that.
Right. That's what I have an issue with. If you're going to have my number, you ain't going to have my name on it. My number.
Yeah.
I want to get paid.
That's where.
If you got a Michigan shirt hanging in there. And it ain't got nothing to do with me on there.
Mm.
All right. But once you put that number on there, I should deserve some money.
Well, here's another thing. Right. You open up a can of worms when you say that because I'm looking at it like, if y'all look at most professional sports, the people who the supply of the league mostly are people that come from players that's not really from these damn marketable schools like that.
What you mean? Well,
Dennis Rodmans and you know what I'm saying? Yeah. All that. So
Division II.
What I'm saying is, like, you know, that's why they should pay him. Because really, Chris Webber ain't no better than fucking Dennis Rodman. Dennis Rodman come out some little, you get what I'm saying? And all across the league is undeveloped players or undrafted players in every sport.
Yeah. So how do you divvy it up? How do you pay somebody from Arkansas State or, you know what I'm saying, little bumfuck Egypt, and then paying somebody from Michigan High Dollar School? I mean, how do you?
That's going to be the issue.
That's
right going
to be the issue.
How do you?
The union. I feel like,
but they don't need the union, man.
I didn't
bring
the union, but I'm saying they're sneaking in there, and that's what's going to happen.
They have an option to unionize. That's what they're looking at now. The union's coming. The lawyers, the hounds is in. They sniff the
sweat. I'm going to tell you what's going to
need at the end of the day, these kids are going to need the union so their voice can be heard.
Take the SEC, for example. They ain't going to allow it at all. They ain't going to allow it. This is $1 billion.
That's
maybe
where
$5-6 billion in the whole
plus
product.
They confederacies.
Okay, exactly.
Yeah, they ain't,
you know
they ain't
what I'm saying?
Shit.
Nope. But, yes, they are. They going to say, all right, you going to go over here and you going to join this, da, 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 da. This is what we're going to pay you. them's gonna be the highest paid players. Right
and
there.
See, that's where it's a weird little area of okay, how you gonna make not us, go to right. get that money you over there. Even though you love Carolina, but if Michigan's wanting to pay you,
and that's I mean, what it's gonna be. Yeah. But at the end of the day, the players will win.
I think so. I think just to let them come to the table as a collective bargaining, they get to come to the table and say, hey, you know, y'all making all this.
Right.
Well, ain't that we got a union, but we want a pot put to the side. And we'll decide, you know what I'm saying? I don't know. I just don't know about
the union. It's going to be the SECs, the ACC, and probably the Pac-10, but the rest of them, they're going to be together.
I don't know. I think I wish the students would somehow just figure a way to keep the older folks out, keep the lawyers out.
Yeah. Impossible.
But if they could really organize and just get a
spell, if they just went off president, if they just went off the word of collective bargaining, instead of bringing the union, just collective bargaining.
The networks is the ones who's going to control
it.
No way, no how.
Look, we're going to take a break. We're going to come back. We got a whole bunch of shit. Y'all stick with it. All right. Welcome back to In Perspective Sports. I'm going to flip it on you for a second. Imagine I'm riding down the road. 10 miles an hour. I make a sudden stop. The cops pull me. And I got a big old grip of pills that are not prescribed to me. I'm high as hell with $29,000. This is just me. I'm going the fuck down. They taking me down. I'm a spectacle. Now, if I'm an owner of an Indianapolis Colts team like Jim Irsay, I don't know. He might not see shit. What y'all think? I think it's crazy as hell, though. He was riding around thugging with 29 G's and pills.
Ooh. They just told him he meant that he was addicted to pills.
That's all he got to do.
He's got a problem in the past.
Yeah, ain't that crazy.
Shit. Going through a divorce.
But if it was a man, it'd be a chain gang, boy. They'd be news media. The whole man, it'd be it. Front page, you know what I'm saying, man?
The pill pusher.
What?
And was he out pushing? Yeah. And was he collecting?
Well, you already know he was
making his, was he making his rounds?
Yeah. And the thing is,
I think they didn't look. At every level of the spectrum, these fucking prescription pills got somebody. From the fucking top, it's a problem at the top of people with money like that, on down the fucking line. And America ain't want to talk about the dirty little secret, which is them fucking pills, man.
Mm-hmm. Hey, but they'd be quick.
He was probably hustling them motherfuckers.
Is that what?
I think he was going to hustle him to some of his buddies.
Might have been the kingpin, right?
Yeah, you know.
This might be a real drug ring.
Kingpin.
You know what I'm saying? As long as he admit, though, they ain't going to go no deeper with the investigation because they unlocked it on
the
pharmacists and all types of fucking pharmaceutical companies is going to go down. You know, they just ain't going to touch that.
Trash
there's no way
bag full of pills.
Trash bag.
$29,000. They threw his ass in rehab. Instead of him going to jail, he's in rehab. He was on the couch watching TV.
Did y'all see him getting taken into custody?
No.
He was a little wobbly.
Wow.
I mean, you know.
Yeah, he was a little wobbly. And when he came out, he was still a little wobbly.
He looked 100 years older.
Yes, he did.
Man,
ain't
no telling
that. He lost weight.
He probably like my man Scarface. You already know. Crush saw here, you know. What's the word we got for it?
No way.
The tweakers.
Yeah.
No, it's not that though. The nodders, nigga. Yeah. The nodders. Yeah.
It was nodding in the car. Yeah.
This motherfucker fell asleep in the car.
Soup lips.
Come to a sudden stop.
Yeah.
Come on. You know what it was.
I ain't gonna get yourself out there
like that. Let's keep it fucking real. Let's talk about how this motherfucker's gonna get off his shit.
Man, shit, you know I ain't gonna get off his shit. Let me say something.
Now,
shit.
Y'all think his shit good? Look what they did to Michael Vick. They crucified him. A year from now, we ain't be talking about this motherfucker.
America.
That's what's fucked up with the NFL. them fucking owners is a band of brothers.
This is America.
He's coming out looking good. It might be a fucking setup for them to. You never fucking know.
Nothing's gonna happen to this. He might get a slap on the wrist.
They ain't gonna hell though. He ain't even
get probation
in his house. They ain't gonna get
probation. Oh, he'll get probation.
Oh, his probation might be give up some
but he got some
zeros.
Felony charges, though.
They're going to make him give up some zeros.
He ain't getting no damn probation.
No, he ain't going to get nothing out of this.
He get a probation officer fired.
I'd be very surprised.
Yeah, he ain't going to get nothing.
Well, he claiming poop. The, yeah. Right, I ain't got to do this.
He claiming poop right now. He ain't going to do right
if something happens to me, I'm going to go ahead and start telling what's going on with this whole ring we in right now. Oh, save his ass. Give him nothing but, you know, the lightest little shit. Let's let this shit go under the rug.
So we start yapping.
This shit ain't going nowhere. All he got to do is just start yapping. Just, hey, you know what? I'm telling.
He might even sell him to a fucking player.
I was getting ready to say that.
We had something called the White House, didn't it? What was that mention they called? Mike said Jerry had four more. The wrench. That house Jerry had for the boys out there to go party in. Dion tried to kill himself coming from the wrench.
Who was that had all that pop? It was that had all that pop.
Nate Newton.
Yeah.
Nate Newton. Robbie Pullman's Jerry. Who ain't got that damn wings Jerry? Hey, these motherfuckers are juicy. Why you think they want a dance, Brent? Damn, Robbie Pullman now. Let's keep it real. I ain't gonna tell him. Nah, that's jokes.
Man, at the end of the day, it is what it is.
You brought up Dez.
Oh, man, yeah. Well, I'm gonna let y'all say that.
I'll try to bring it up a little something. It was at age 25, he's sitting under a whole different set of rules. I just seen this for myself. He sits under a whole different set of rules that Jerry gave him. Like, he can't drink, he can't go to strip clubs. You gotta be in a 12. You know, other little shit that other, you know, people didn't have to be under.
Cause college
like
kid.
He's their dude or whatnot or whatever. But I was like, he's 25. Mm-hmm. What kind of shit is this? I mean, I heard of other coaches like, you know, Edwards.
Did
he
that
empty
smack the
mom. He did that to Pac-Man.
Sure. I mean, I don't give a fuck, man. Come on, man. Damn.
This man's a ticking time bomb, bro.
Yeah. Is that what it is?
He's a ticking
time bomb. So he's crazy?
Can he do that? Something wrong with you? Is GMRSA selling you some stuff?
Damn.
Come on, with the man. Don't be bad.
Nah, but seriously, no way.
Let that man quit. It's fucked up. It's fucked up.
So listen, this is what it is, though. Jerry Jones said that he comes out of his little contract in a year or so, and said Jerry wants him to still stick with that regiment after that. He even chimed in lately and said that shit's not even true. He's not really under that regiment right now.
Yeah, he is.
And what happened to Michael Jordan?
He's
under Jordan.
Surveillance and everything. Y'all didn't know that?
That's what I figured. Yeah.
What happened to that?
What?
Jordan was supposed to mentor this guy. What happened with that?
Look.
I can't see that.
I can see that. You're right. Mm. But not him, no way. No way, no how.
No, this is what's going on. No how. But fucking, I'm going to be honest with y'all, man. This, to me personally, this is like some slave shit. This is saying you can't leave the fucking yard. You can't even go hang around your people. You can't go do none of this, that, other. I mean, look at it from a different perspective. He's telling this man he can't really go off the plantation, people.
Come on, man, that's crazy.
And I'm going to tell you something else. Hold up now. This is fucked up. I'm a Cowboy fan, and this is the racist bullshit. You gave that fucking punk-ass Tony Romo $120 million fucking dollars.
Preach!
And 50 of it fucking guaranteed. And he's going to shit this nigga this year, putting that bad scandal all around him.
And
he owes that boy a bunch of fucking money.
And you're cutting him off to swear.
Yeah, well, you got to pay some people.
Well, they gave Romo the money.
But this is a bargaining chip for Jerry. Boy, you want to stay in Dallas? I hell you, like, you know, it's going to be something happening this year. Watch. Yeah. Don't fucking watch. Watch. It's going to be some bullshit. This is already some bullshit. Let's be honest about this. These white men that are journalists, I hate to use the white-black thing, that are fucking journalists, don't have the right to go into these young black men's lives the way they fucking do. Mm-hmm. And put that shit on TV. We don't know what the rest of the world fucking makes. Mm-hmm. I don't think, you know, think about that. In corporate America, you don't know what anybody makes. But in the fuck, it's all right to tell what the fuck the niggas fucking make. They don't tell us what these fucking owners make. And put all their business out here like that. Why? These niggas need to sue the fucking league and stick the fuck together and y'all can own that shit. But if they're long, they're being fucking slaves, they're gonna get treated like a fucking slave.
And that's the
They got a jerk chain around his neck.
That's
electric car.
That's the thing you realize. Dez Bryant signed off on
and to get ready, shit him out some money.
Dez Bryant signed off on that shit.
Yeah, he did. When he was young, he didn't have no daddy.
I understand.
Well, now, RG3's daddy, his daddy, you know, them boys, is, you know, some of these boys, Cam daddy, and they protecting their boys.
Yeah, they are.
Fuck that, Dirt Road brother. Fuck y'all. I can speak to my brother. He can't, but I can. Now, hey, listen, he shit that boy out some money the first time. By him being damaged goods coming out of draft. Look. Hey, listen, Jerry's marketing this boy as well. Okay, you're going to look like the bad guy, Diz. Mm-hmm.
bad.
He's already looking like bad. That well, that's knocking a million out of Dad's fucking endorsement things and in contract years. Now, everybody is fucking wanting to be interested in Dad's. It's going to pitch at the Dad's. But Dad, you know you're in some trouble.
Right.
Yeah.
Keeping that money.
And this nigga's mentality is, I got to go in here and take what the fuck I can get instead of ask what the fuck I want. It's real nigga shit. Fuck that bullshit.
Which leaves Jerry Jones sitting there holding the money like,
I'm serious, man. I hate to get off to take it over, man. That's some fucking bullshit. Y'all better wake the fuck up, man. That's some fucking bullshit. Jerry Jones, I ain't even Cowboy fan no more. I love him to death, but fuck that redneck motherfucker. I'm sorry, y'all.
Look for them losers.
He gonna make his boy look bad and Tony Romo look like the Garo.
Got that billion-dollar toilet.
That's bullshit.
But it goes back to like, billion-dollar toilet.
When we was talking about Steve Smith, you know what I'm saying? How the Panthers done it. Oh, he was a problem, you know what I'm saying? Sorry, he go to Baltimore, he get his money, you know?
It's
just bullshit, man.
What he's saying is what us Cowboys talk about behind closed doors.
I like Cam Newton. I hate to say it, but damn it. It is what it is. Fuck Jerry.
Nah, I feel you.
Shit.
Fuck him.
Could have had Cam Newton in that motherfucker. Could have had the boy that just won a championship up in that motherfucker. A lot of niggas. Right, Vic.
Could have had Randy Moss.
Vince Young.
Could have had Randy Moss.
Man, fuck Jerry. My bad, y'all, but fuck
it. Nah, you good.
No.
Speak on it.
That come from a Cowboy fan.
Yes,
that's
sir,
some
I'm
real
a die
shit.
I'm a Cowboy, but fuck niggas from, hey, man, that star on the end with me something different. And I know what it means.
Can I hit it one time?
No way, no how.
Pay that nigga.
We'll be right back in Perspective Sports. All right, welcome back to the In Perspective Sports Show. All right. We did brackets, a few of us anyway. A few people were too scared to turn them in.
I knew
it's all good though, because we know it's gonna be
crazy.
It's crazy. I will say this at first. We do. Who's left in the brackets? Who's the winners left with? I think you got that one over there. Who's left?
Let's see. In the West, you got Arizona, San Diego State, Baylor, and Wisconsin.
Right.
Midwest, you got Kentucky, Louisville, Tennessee, and Michigan. Mm-hmm. The East, you got Virginia, Michigan State, Iowa State, and UConn. And in the South, you got Florida, UCLA, Dayton, and Stanford.
Sounds wonderful. But it sucks because my niggas ain't on there. Can't, I don't know what the fuck happened to you. But
I know what happened. When Bryce Johnson got hurt.
Mm-hmm. That was a wrap. I'm
going to tell you what happened also. Sorry, let me just chime in for a second. Roy, goddammit, why you don't put a full court press on? With fucking, what, 15.7? I mean, I don't even know what it was. Like, Roy, what you doing? I mean, he backed off and really... This dude that scored, he was crushing our ass. You think he'd have been the dude to score on us? Fuck no, that nigga would have got crushed by me. He would not have been the dude to get us. Everybody, I knew it was going to him. Like, Roy, come on, man. I think Roy's asleep.
To me,
he don't know the game. I don't know what the fuck. Fuck him. I'm ready for him to go.
To me, he messed up. He messed up kind of earlier than that. To me, Meacham was getting off. And it was like every time Meacham was getting in his groove, he'd take him out and put the dude, what's his name, selling in or whoever it was.
Yeah.
Then throw Meach back in. When Meach was handling it, I'm sorry, I'd have kept him in the game. I wouldn't have took him out.
I'm talking about Meach.
Meach
was like, hey, look, he brought the white boy in. At the last play of the game, he brings the white boy in. And that's when dude comes down and, you know, that gets the last. I'm like, why did he take Meach out? Like, say, I think Roy's fucking old and tired and get his... Sorry, go back to Kansas, man.
Click the heels and
can't
go
even
back.
Beat Kansas anyway.
No place.
I will go through this though. I will say that right now,
playoff Roy. Now,
let me see. I got probably one of the lowest ones outside of Sherman, who's at the bottom of 41.
That's what you expect from a Duke. That's what you expect
from a Duke. I love my Dukies though. I love my Dukies.
Y'all can't even get out of the state.
Yeah, right.
They had a shorter route back this time.
That was pretty fucking bad.
They didn't even have a route.
Y'all walked. Y'all jog back home. Coach K made y'all run back home.
He made carry bags. For real,
y'all got something there.
Mercer.
Oh, man.
Hey, we lost in the big thing.
Lord have mercy.
Mercer.
I mean, y'all was more fresh than we were.
Lord have mercy.
Hey, wait a minute. Y'all got Alice in the first round.
No how.
There ain't no how.
Getting with these Carolina fans. Look,
I'll tell you this. That's why Coach K is leaving in 5 years. He's tired of these first round buys. That's a whole new meaning.
No, we
first
got round national championship buys. Watch.
Okay, but y'all been saying that and saying that. And we're still that. Watching and waiting.
But I will say this. Hold on. Sherman's at the bottom of 41. I'm right behind him at 44. Ghost.
I'm winning.
He's got nine. He only wants to choose. He only wants to choose three or four teams. So he want to get into the real deal of it. Oh,
so he got to pick up no points.
He's got nine. He got some all right picks out of that, but he's at the bottom actually.
Yeah.
And we got Chris John coming in at 51 after that. Mm-hmm. In second place is Brandon Hendricks at 55, and Dwayne Elliott. Right now, you're the N Sports champ right now, baby, with the bracket. So. We'll see what happens at the end. I don't know what's going to happen. We're going to see.
Wow. I'm going to come back and win it. Come on, Florida.
Back to some football, though. They making some changes. I don't know. I think corporate's coming in all over the place in football.
What's up with these changes?
They're talking about, I think they're talking about no dunking the goal. Because the white men can't jump.
Well, Jimmy Graham got some white in him.
Yeah. They talk about for the first 2 weeks of the preseason, they'll put the PAT on the 20-yard line. What? I think that's pretty good. Yeah. I always thought that should like push it back a little bit.
I can make the extra point from where it is now.
I like that.
Unless
you go for 2 points, then they put it on the regular spot.
I can dig that.
You give them the 2 points when they score.
Yes, sir.
If they don't score.
I wish they just done away with it. I want to see 2 points anyway.
Yeah.
Makes the game move.
You don't want to see them
kicking?
No kicking. Take the soccer boys out of football.
They need to take part.
I mean, no. They can kick it off. Or you can still do the field goals.
No. They can kick it off.
They can kick it off and they still do the field goals. You can still do the field goals.
Take the punt.
But when you make that touchdown, line it back up and go for two. Man it up because it changes the game. That 2 points changes the game, dude. Let's do it.
You're saying only for the
man
three
up.
Points.
Yes, only if you need to line up. If it's fourth and four, and you got one that can kick anywhere, even you on the 1 yard line. You know what I'm saying? You kick at 3 points. Hey, that's 3 points right there. But you make that touchdown. Ain't no need for that man. Come on, line them back up. And let's do it, man.
So
pop one.
So do. Well, what about moving
right. back though? 20 to the 20 yard line.
If you ain't, if you're not gonna leave it like it is, just do away with it. Period. For real, it was just one point.
Say, I mean, like, Willa could kick that shit right
yeah.
now.
Yeah, but still, it's just one point. It's just one point.
But, I don't know. I never knew why soccer boys was in football, it's different.
I love football. I like going to Pop Warner just for the simple fact of, whenever they run that touchdown, you ain't got to worry about all that. You're going to line it back up, boom, and it changes the game big time because if you make your extra points, you know what I'm saying? You miss one or two. That's really a difference in the ball game. You see what I'm saying?
Right. I mean, I can dig that. Ain't nothing wrong with it. How about this, though? They're possibly talking about widening the goalpost 5 feet.
That's some bullshit.
Yeah.
What the
I don't know.
What the fuck is this nigga doing? Hey, go there. You need to stop.
He won that 80 yarder.
He likes attention. He's an attention whore. Yeah. He do some stupid shit.
I don't know, man. I mean, to keep the game,
he's going to be known as the motherfucker that changed football.
But do you want to be known as the motherfucker that didn't do shit? I mean, that's what I was thinking.
You can't change the fucking league. Baseball don't do it.
All he's doing is basically putting it back how it used to be back in the day. Then why even mess with it? You remember when they narrowed it?
Yeah.
If he does that, it's going back to regular style, like high school.
Well, I mean, if they push it back. I ain't gonna really argue about the 5 feet too much because they're pushing them back. So
you talking about the whole field goal?
Is he making
the field goal wider?
Wider, gonna make it like it is in high
school.
What's
next? He making the field smaller, 40 yards?
That's where I'm
80 yards long and 40 wide?
I say it's that corporate shit, make them changes for some fucking odd reason to make you
sell more fucking space.
Yeah, I mean, it's all some weird crunch.
I don't know.
Money crunch bullshit.
I don't know.
It's guaranteeing more field goals.
Okay.
Either that or they got to do away with them because they more of them missing field goals.
What you talking about? The extra point ones?
No, them long ones.
Yeah.
And more now, teams waste timeouts trying to stop it. It's right. More air time.
Yep.
So what you saying?
Which makes the game longer.
Which makes the game longer, more money.
Which is cool, which ain't cool. What y'all saying about that? What?
If I'm getting checks, I'm cool. Right. But if not, fuck it.
So for the game of football, though?
It's bad.
Okay.
He just won't stop, man. He's every fucking year some damn rule changes. Don't y'all
agree? They're just trying to add points, make the game have more points, and that widening is going to add.
Well, I mean, maybe for those whack-ass, slow-ass games like when you see Dallas and, you know, Pittsburgh play.
Hold on, though.
You know, it'll make that shit a little bit more live. I'm talking shit, but, you know, that's what we do. But I'm just saying, it might make the games a little more live and where it was going to be some dead shit. Where,
well, what if, okay. Why don't we? Go ahead.
I'm just saying.
Let's go back to the ground and pound. True. I want to see 21-7.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? Some nose bleeding or something. I don't need to see no 35-48.
Why don't they make him wear pads anymore?
That's their fault.
Who? What?
Yeah, they got it right. Talking about the knee pads and everything.
No, they should make him wear that.
That's their right. Fault. That's
they make him wear helmet. They should make him wear all the pads.
If I was in NFL, that's where a lot of the injuries are coming from.
That's true. Shit.
But that's their right. Look like going out there with some
everybody.
You notice this?
No, they don't.
No hip pads, no thigh pads.
They don't have no knee pads, no thigh pads.
They just with stretch pants, Pete.
You know, everybody.
Big, dumb, stupid mother.
Hold on, I
know that. No way, no how.
Hold up, though.
I'll take it even deeper.
You didn't know that.
You know a lot of the quarterbacks and wide receivers wear the fucking field goal kickers, shoulder pads, anything to get faster.
Well, that's how you keep your job.
They've been doing that
smaller
shit.
Smaller pads, man.
They've been doing that shit.
Smaller pads, but damn, you're on your legs.
Man, I'm in with the shorter pads. All these fucking pads.
Why do you think RG3 got fucked up? I want no damn thigh pads or nothing, no?
They some dumb ass motherfuckers. I'm sorry. I ain't feeling that one.
Oh, I'm going.
Hold up now.
I'm going fully equipped.
No, if you slower, yes, three steps slower on a 50 yards, you won't even get in there. Well, that's what the fuck that is.
I'm a last.
Thank you.
I'm a last. You can't get there.
I'm a last.
It's just starting college. They don't wear them in college no more.
I'm going to have a juke move for
you. I'm
ass.
Going fully
y'all
equipped.
Know that.
Mouthpiece too.
Shit.
That's right.
Well, if you was Flash, though, but some of these motherfuckers just, they cheating. I mean, that's cheating to me. You cheating the game, and you about to cheat yourself, you get hurt.
Thank
like,
you.
Shut the fuck up if you got hurt. I don't even know if you should be, if you didn't wear the proper uniform, you might not be able to get no money from me if you took your bitch ass out there and didn't have your pads on. That's just me.
The commissioner should do that. The commissioner should do that.
Y'all just hit it on the head. Why you think they ain't making them do it? It goes back to, you remember when Jobs used to make you wear back braces to prevent you from hurting your back?
Right.
Okay, and then they took it out. So if you hurt your back, it is what it is. It's an option to wear a back brace. Well, it's the same now.
That's that.
So in 20 years from now, when they grumbling, complaining how they broke up, well, motherfucker, you should have wore your pads.
Mm-hmm. I mean, you had your pads.
That was my point exactly.
When I was at
Commission, will make some changes, there. That was the point.
Right.
When I was at Freedom, we had to wear knee braces.
Yeah.
Had to. For protection of yourself and the future.
It was heavy as hell.
You know what, though? Man, I want to outrun you, so I ain't even going to wear no pants, son. Mm-hmm. I'm the fastest in the field, son. Mm-hmm. Call me the dumbest one.
But you know that, that goes back to where that goes back to where that dope is from. It's like, you know, that goes back to where that doping comes back in. You know,
when Coach Maggie was there,
you know, that keeping them doctors paid, you know.
When Coach Maggie was coaching at Freedom, we all had to wear knee braces.
I mean, I ain't mad at that shit.
Fuck Coach Mabry.
Mabry. He was there before Coach Stout.
No, I know Mr. Mabry. Fuck you if you're out there somewhere.
Oh, shit. Also,
Mabry.
What about this? When the NFL, they talking about not stopping the clock after a sack.
I'm with
trying
that.
Trying
to speak the game up.
I'm with that.
I ain't mad at it.
Hey, also, now get quarterbacks, man, up. Yes, now, sir. Get your ass up off the damn
ground
now.
That's why I like it. Ain't
get
no
your
milk,
ass
get your
up
ass
off
ass
the
up.
Ground now.
Get your
good,
ass
good
up.
Rule change? Commissioner?
Ah, hell no. That's NFL ball. I want to see Warren Sapp because I didn't do his damn dance. Leave him up fucking alone, man.
He still can do his dance.
No, you can't. You're not going back to the next play. Or you get the damn game or some shit.
You think the quarterback just going to pop up?
How you
going
to see Warren Sapp when he retired?
I'm talking about, like, you know, the show. Or the Jared Allen. What the fuck
you
do?
Yeah, if you really have one sack, the quarterback just going to pop up.
Look, they going to have to now.
Yeah.
They're going
to be hurt. But I don't know
they
about
gonna
that.
They're
going
to be hurt. You're getting paid the big bucks. Like you better get your ass
you
up.
Just don't like because they're old ragged-ass RG3.
You goddamn right. Protect my man. Let him fucking take his time.
He better learn how to protect himself.
I got to check my
quarterback's
back.
Twinkle toes.
And
he
still
playing.
Fuck you, dick.
And he still playing.
Welcome back to In Perspective Sports. I tell you what, boy, my man got robbed. I mean, I like Bradley, but Pacquiao's my motherfucker. I'm sorry. I think Bradley's going to get his ass whooped in this one.
You've been running him out a little bit too much.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Pacquiao Bradley.
He done whooped his ass one time.
Oh, the judges, the judges whooped Manny's ass.
Pacquiao is washed up.
Who got whooped?
Pacquiao is washed up.
You are out of your freaking mind. What are you talking about?
Gone. Cotto's gone.
Oh, he's got a fight on his hands.
He's got a hand.
He's
going to
get his ass. He's going to get knocked out. He's
moving
up. Sergio?
He's moving up.
He's moving up. He's going back to his real way.
Hold up.
Well, back to the conversation that we was talking about. Okay, sorry. Pacquiao, on the other hand, he's washed up.
Nah, man.
He has too much on his plate.
Nah. Didn't he knock your man out?
This is a big fight.
Didn't he knock your man out?
After my man got beat up with rocks. With cement. With cement. It was the next fight.
With Margarito, and Cotto, that was before.
And then we fought Pacquiao.
Ran through the ringer.
But anyway, Pacquiao.
He's not done, man. Fuck that.
He's got too much on his plate, Pete.
No, he's focused now, bro.
No,
he's focused now. I think he's focused, and I think this boy's getting ready.
So you think Bradley's going to win the fight?
It's going to be ugly.
It's going to be ugly for Bradley.
I think it's going to be one of the best ones of 2014. I don't care what comes up. It's going to be one of them.
Bradley going to tie him up for his red headbutt him like he normally do.
Bradley's the new Mayweather.
That's what they want.
Bradley's the new Mayweather.
And that's what's scary about it.
Why are we talking about that
cow? And that's what's scary about it.
Yeah. They replace
who's going to replace Mayweather right now? And it's going to be Timothy Bradley.
He's got a Z, zero.
They're not going to let all them titles go back.
Andre Ward's going to be awesome.
Pacquiao. There's no way.
Shit, it might
Pacquiao was getting ready to take boxing back over there.
That dude that he that's where, a couple weeks ago and spanked that
That's
dude,
where he
man.
Was going to do his pay-per-views at.
Hey, he's nice.
Yes. What? You know how much money he can make over there?
Floyd took him down a bit.
He'd sell out
but
arenas.
He's young, he's nice, though, man.
He wasn't ready for Floyd. I'll give you that, Floyd.
I'll give you that,
Floyd.
But that fight he fought on a couple of
times. Pacquiao's not going to take his title over there.
I didn't take my hat off to him, man.
Maybe one or two, but you're talking about every fight.
One or two's all he got left.
Shit. You tripping.
America tripping.
All I got to say is this. Bradley, be careful what you wish for. I'm taking my glasses off on this one. Be careful what you wish for, because you just might get it. You said Pacquiao's going to knock you, got to knock you out to win? Pacquiao, a knockout. You heard it here.
No way.
Shut up.
Wow. He just told you right there. He has to knock him out. No,
well, he's going
to
do
an ugly fight. He's going to tie
him
up.
So you don't think that he can knock him out?
He's going to knock him out.
I see that.
He don't have the knockout power no more.
Who don't?
Pacquiao.
And Bradley does?
When's the last time he knocked someone out?
Your boy.
When's the last time he knocked someone out?
When's the last time Bradley knocked someone out?
When is the last time Pacquiao knocked someone out?
That's a mean Your boy? 2009.
You understand what I'm saying?
Do you hear me?
2009.
He was your boy. He's your boy.
That's a long time.
When's the last time your man said,
knocked somebody out?
The last time. Last year.
Before that bullshit scrub fight. It was a nobody from nowhere.
Well, oh, it was Casamayor.
It wasn't even Pacquiao. What does Pacquio have?
Come on, man.
You living serious? Off the back days. Come on, man. What you talking about now?
The man got robbed.
So
he got robbed and got ducked. He got robbed and got ducked.
What are you As want? My man Steve Come Smith on, says, man. Ice up, son.
Bullshit.
Yeah, he's icing up in Baltimore, too.
That's a 10. Fuck
that. He's icing up in Baltimore.
That's a 11, that's a 12, that's a 13.
Goddamn it.
That's some whack shit.
Shit.
That's
some whack shit.
I'm going to put my glasses back on. I made my point.
But look, shit. Fuck that. Everybody come and check out Menage A Fashions, 128 West Union. You know what I'm saying? We got Keisha Nichols off the basketball wipes coming in, taking pictures and selling t-shirts.
Big time.
Come and fuck with us. We're going to be doing our thing up in there. Come and see us. It's like 2 to maybe 6. Come and fuck with us.
I heard you guys are going to be doing something in Charlotte. You know, it's kind of big.
Yeah. We also got some fashion shows coming up. Come and fuck with us April the 10th. We're going to be at a club called Oso. And at, on April the 26th, we'll be at... I'll get you the information, but it's downtown Charlotte. Come and fuck with us. Come and fuck with us. It's
and,
going down, baby.
I'll be at the Exxon, Lucky's Exxon. Signing autographs. Friday from 5 to 5:30. And pictures are $10. Take one with you. Bring your kids
back. That's what's
I got
up,
a sponsor.
Who's your sponsor?
Lucky's Exxon. Right up my birthday.
In respect to sports, you heard that shit.
I didn't hear that, money.
Deuces. We'll see you next week. Peace out. Yeah.